right here on FS1. Let's head over, check in with Colin Coward today. Hey, Colin, what is on the show?
Zion Williamson, do not go to New Orleans. You have not been drafted yet. It's your life. You deserve better. We'll talk about that coming up.
Interesting. All right, Colin, thank you. Time for our final topic of the day. The Raptors are on the road tonight against the Bucks in game one of the Eastern Conference Finals. The Greek Freak and his Bucks are favored by 6.5 points tonight, and they won 3 of the 4 meetings with Toronto this season. But Kawhi Leonard is coming off his miracle game winner, and he averaged about 35 points per game in their last series.
Way to go, Jenny.
I knew you would like that. Shannon, what is the score tonight?
I got the Bucks winning this one, 104-96.
I thought number two was the
best player. Vegas has the line at 6.5, so I'm really willing to give you that.
Yeah.
Plus another extra. I expect Kawhi to be great again.
But they're going to lose?
Yeah, they're going to lose. Because as Kawhi was great the last game, nobody else really did a whole lot.
Oh, really?
Yep. So 104-96.
104-96.
Okay. So the weird thing about the 4 regular season meetings was that the underdog won all 4 of them. But tonight, I think the favorite will win slightly, though, again, the underdog's going to cover the spread.
You want 8? You
want
6?
I don't want any of this. I don't want any of this.
So you're out on number 2. You don't even want to bet on him, huh?
Well, you won't bet on him.
He's better than Giannis, but that's
not
good.
I'll take the Bucks head up, just straight up, for a case, right?
No, I got the Bucks to win the series.
You told me he's the best player on the floor.
Yeah.
Isn't he?
Best player, not best team.
Huh? Really? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, why wouldn't he pull off another miracle?
There'll be time.
He might luck in a shot to win this game.
There'll be time.
I'll give you right now. I'll take the Bucks straight up for a case.
No.
Yep. Why not?
No.
Why not? Yes. See.
I don't like to get bet against my own self-interest.
Right. Own self-interest.
Yeah.
What are you gonna do with that? Will AD be a Laker next season?
I think the only way Anthony Davis will wind up as a Laker, LeBron wants Anthony Davis in L.A. He's obviously, went out of his way to do that.
He didn't go out of his way.
Yeah, he went out of his way. He alienated the entire team.
He
went
out of his whole team.
Yeah, he wrecked it.
Anthony Davis said, "I want to leave New Orleans."
And then LeBron James was ready to get rid of the entire team. But you know what? LeBron James might really want Anthony Davis in L.A. Well, I think because it's Linda Ramis's world, we're all just living in it.
Yeah.
They might say, "Okay, you want him in L.A.? You're going to New Orleans, LeBron James."
Uh-huh.
Do not be surprised if they trade LeBron James. They have 2 more years that are guaranteed. It is obviously a circus. Some of it's LeBron. Some of it is Jeannie Buss and Linda Rambis. Who, by the way, you guys are sports people. Who is Linda Rambis? Well, why did she become a part of my daily conversation?
Tell me so we'll both know.
Okay, I never heard of this woman.
She's been with the Lakers for years.
Jeannie's best friend.
I'm going to tell you something. Let me tell you something. I personally was at the courthouse when we evicted Kurt Rambis and Phil Jackson from New York. I thought he was done. Go to Minnesota. Go to the woods in Montana.
You were there.
I was there. We evicted them. Bye-bye. Get out of here. And now all of a sudden, Linda Rambis is in charge, which we all know has to do with Kurt Rambis. This is craziness. I feel sorry for your guy.
Yeah.
But he might wind up, your friend, LeBron James, mm-hmm. Goatman,
yep.
He might wind up getting traded to the New Orleans Pelicans. Mm. And you heard it here first.
Wow.
Do not think it could happen,
Shannon. I still ain't drinking no smoothies, so I don't care where he goes. But look here, we're going to win. Wherever we go, we're going to win.
We would say we. Last week, it was the Houston Rockets. We.
No, we. LeBron is a we.
Okay, but last week, it was we about Houston Rockets. By the way, you're the biggest Golden State Warrior hater out there.
I picked the Warriors.
You are we with the Houston Rockets.
Mm. As I was saying, I'm sorry, I'm so rudely interrupted. Mm-hmm. I like our chances now. Since we got that 4th pick, we got to pick.
Who is our? I don't even know who our.
Lakers.
I can't keep up.
Lakers. Yeah, I can't keep up.
I'm going to stay a little while longer.
Okay.
I'm not one of these guys that jumps on and off bandwagons. That's not what I do.
Who are you affiliated with now? Just the Lakers? I just want to make it clear.
I'm affiliated with LeBron.
Okay.
You should have a running list.
I'm a LeBron.
I'm just writing that down.
I'm a LeBron.
Okay.
And Kawhi right now. And Kawhi.
He ain't
your
here.
Own Kawhi.
He ain't coming here.
But anyway, I say we got a 75% chance.
Mm.
And who do you get rid of? Who do you get rid of?
We got that 4th pick.
The 4th pick.
There's a possibility, you heard the rumbling, that Lonzo Ball might get traded to Chicago for the 7th pick.
Mm-hmm.
So we'd be willing to give you the 4th, the 7th pick.
We need players.
Okay, you want a young player? You want a young player? You want Kuzma?
The good luck charm? Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, and Kuzma. And
maybe a couple
a
more.
A 2 pick, an ice pick, and an afro pick. So that's 5 picks.
And then you got 2 years to win a championship. And I can tell you this, I'd bet every case of Mountain Dew, everything I have in
Let
the
bank. Let KD leave Golden State.
Let me tell you something. You ain't winning a championship next year no matter what.
Let KD leave Golden State and the Lakers get AD and bang, bang.
You're not winning a champ. The basketball gods don't work like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, they do. That's how they work.
They don't work like that for anybody, whether it's Michael Jordan, Isaiah Thomas, the Celtics, Golden State Warriors.
Hey, we might get Kyrie. You see, y'all, you
talking. You ain't winning no championship next year, which means you got one more year.
Hmm. So, Michael Rappaport, let me ask you a question. I need your wisdom here.
Okay, thank you.
If you were in Anthony Davis's shoes this morning and you were still shell-shocked by the news that your franchise that you still work for just landed Zion, and if you leave that franchise, you leave $70 million on that table in New Orleans because that's how much of a haircut, a Ooh. Bald cut that you're going to have to take mm-hmm. to go to L.A.
Brow
because
cut.
The money to be made is to stay put. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So all of a sudden, you're thinking, gee, I could play with Zion, and if we lose Julius Randle, which it looks like they will, they're going to open up a slot of $25 to $30 million where they could go get one of the big free agents, maybe not the top guys, but somebody credible, somebody who could fill a role alongside Drew Holiday. So,
yes, sir.
So all of a sudden, you've got a basketball team in New Orleans. So why would you want to leave that for Linda Rambis? That's the question. Would you really want to go work for Linda Rambis?
The reason why you would do this is because of bad advice.
Okay.
If I was Anthony Davis right now, the first thing I would do is fire my agent. Bad advice.
I told you that earlier. That
okay,
might be the next
advice.
Sneaker to fall.
A guy who everybody loves.
Yep.
Who wasn't a disruption. He became a disruption this year in New Orleans.
Because he wanted out.
Biggity, biggity, bye-bye, folks. That's a disruption.
Yeah, that's all, folks.
That's not fair.
Yeah, it is
Think
very
how
fair.
Much that's he just, was
how about
liked.
This here?
He was
he
loved.
Shifted.
Wait, I haven't heard the end of his analysis here.
No. If I were him, number one, I'd fire my agents. Okay, bad representation. And I would try to reset with New Orleans because that's a lot of money. You and see if the fans will accept him back.
Oh, now we've got to beg for the fans to accept me back.
Yeah, because he disrespected the whole city.
I'm gone. Mm. I'm out.
The fans loved him. He loved the fans.
How about this here? AD wants out. You saw Zion's face last night. He doesn't want in.
He was shell-shocked, too. It's like, what?
How about this here? How much you willing to bet Zion Williamson doesn't play his entire career in New Orleans? He loves it so much. He's going to love it so much. Let me tell you what's going to happen. He'll play that first 4 years. Then he'll get that rookie contract because it's so right thing to do because we've seen no one leave a team without getting that big rookie payday.
Mm.
And then 2 years into that big rookie payday, he dip it.
Mm. And you know who he got that from?
Don't worry about who he
get
got
that
it
from.
Don't worry about all
who
that.
Who ruined the NBA? Your guy. All these guys grew up loving this guy, and they go to him for bad advice.
Mm.
This is what happened. Mm. This is the domino effect, and now he's on the way out. Mm. Now he's on the way out.
He ain't on the way nowhere. Mm. He ain't going nowhere.
So I got to ask, when we talk about the New Orleans Saints, do we always put it in the perspective of they're playing in the smallest media market in the country?
Nope,
nobody ever says that.
Hold on, basketball.
They're done with the Saints.
Hold on, first of all, now you know basketball superstars and football superstars is something entirely different.
Different market.
Do free agents want to play for the Saints? Sure they do.
Yes.
Yeah,
but basketball,
no,
I will say basketball.
They go to the highest bidder.
Okay. Does Alvin Kamara want out of New Orleans? Does he say, I got to get somewhere where there's bigger media market? No, he's not saying. He loves what he's doing.
He don't no choice. But see, those basketball superstars, they have a choice. They swing the stars swing. Tom Brady doesn't swing the pendulum of power.
Mm.
Tom Brady is as good as they've ever been.
Mm-hmm.
He ain't more popular than LeBron James.
Mm.
He ain't popular than Steph Curry. That's the way it works, Skip Bayless. So when you get those guys that can swing the needle, they swing it.
But it's because of the sport.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Not the city.
No. The sport. And they want to be big, viable markets. Now, look, they've been, there's no question. But Anthony Davis, we review Anthony Davis different. He putting up those numbers in Boston, L.A., or the Knicks.
Mm.
Now, we're talking about something.
But you got to win. Numbers got
to
win.
That's why he coming to L.A.
He ain't coming to L.A. Oh, come to L.A.
Wait, time out. Are you sure that LeBron is more popular than Tom Brady? Because I'm not sure about that.
I knew you'd catch that.
I'm not sure
check
because...
Check Twitter.
Okay,
check
well,
IG.
We'll check
IG. Check jersey sales.
Check the latest... Wait. Thank you for bringing that up. Latest jersey sales in the National Football League led by Tom Brady. He's going on 42.
Check basketball. Check basketball. Number one sales, Tom Brady. Well, who has a bigger brand, Tom Brady or LeBron James?
Well, LeBron James does every single thing and the kitchen sink to build his brand. Tom Brady's just like, I'm winning these rings and things.
What's the TB12 method? If he ain't doing nothing, what's the
TB12? He's not out there tweeting. Out there trolling.
I'm sorry he doesn't have the personality to do movies or do TV.
We're going to see about that.
We're going to see about
Space Jam 2. The loser's doing a Space Jam 2.
Whoa.
He can't even recruit other NBA players.
Hey, he got to go to Facebook. Bronny put nothing on Facebook. Big time movie studios. Warner Brothers said we got $200 million to do Space Jam 2.
We'll see if it gets done.
How much he get for doing the documentary on Facebook?
We'll see if it gets done.
$200 million.
Who?
That's what LeBron got to do Space Jam. That's what the budget. $200 million.
If it gets done.
They'll cut Bron a check.
Hey, they cut a lot of checks in L.A. Pay or play. They'll pay them.
Hey.
They might not play with them.
Hey, they don't cut the check. Look at Denzel. When they say, Denzel, we want you to do a movie, they the direct deposit $20-25 million account. Now, whether the movie get made or not, that ain't on me.
Yes.
Jenner Sharp.
Yes.
Last night, bottom line takeaway. You lost Anthony Davis and you lost Zion. That's what happened. That's the bottom line.
75%
it happened.
It.
A boom, boom. Simultaneously, they're going to stay together in New Orleans.
A split second.
You want to put some dude on that? Mm-hmm. Let's bet all 33 cases.
I don't need.
All of them?
All of them.
I feel like you guys are talking about this all day.
Can I say one final thing
one
to
last
my friend
thing.
Skip?
Yes.
Skip. I love you. No, I listen to the show when I'm not on.
Start.
I just want to say
bring
this.
It up.
I'm concerned about
don't
your Kawhi derangement
don't
syndrome.
Don't say his name. You can't say his name
I'm
on
sorry.
This show.
I'm sorry. I just want to say
he
I am
will
concerned.
Always be number two to me.
I'm just concerned as a fan when I listen. I'm like, my guy has Kawhi derangement syndrome.
Was that
syndrome.
Not the luckiest shot you've ever seen?
Not at all.
It was
I like to be with you to get him. I was listening. I was like, my guy's got drinking.
Can you imagine Kawhi and LeBron?
That's not happening.
Michael, Kawhi we need more time for this one. Would you come back another day to
Anytime.
Talk about Kawhi?
I love you guys, and I love the show.
I feel
show.
Like that'd be good conversation.
Hopefully we have better news
Thank
when we come
you
back.
For being here. Let's talk about Shannon. Is he going to admit he actually likes Tom Brady? Maybe you're buying a jersey.